My name is Christian Hoberstorfer, and I am a producer, project leader, which is called in Swedish, at the Swedish Television Drama Department in Stockholm. I think we can not underestimate the impact of Stieg Larsson and his Millennium trilogy. I think that's an eye-opener for the whole world. And I don't have the figures, but I think it's one of the biggest sales of books ever in Sweden. So I would say the trend started there in some ways. And also, of course, the Danish wonder of TV series. So it's as usual, it's one kind of window which opens suddenly and everybody's there. And also I think it's a question of the globalization that people are seeking content, exotic content, and still are connected to traditional genres. So I think it's a mix between this all these topics.
She's one of the best investigators I have.
But
I'm concerned you won't like her. She's different.
In what way?
In every way.
I would describe the trends in Swedish drama, or the way we are going at the moment, is fantastic, and I think it's a combination of generations. It's coming a new generation. We are trained in. We have been watching so much series all the time. So we have one kind of modern drama language, and connected that to beware of the genre, and also beware of the classical way of telling stories. That mix, I think, is one of the key things. We are very dependent on adaptations, and I would say that's also one of our problems. Take The Bridge, for example. That's an original series. And I would say that's one of the challenges we have, to find originated and finding ways to develop drama. So I would say that's the key thing. I would not say it's easy to adaptate books, but we need both. And if you see at the Oscars, you can have an Oscar for original screenplay, and you can also have it for adaptation. That says a little bit about the differences. It's different things, but I would say that it's one big challenge for us. The bridge role in changing Swedish television and Swedish drama is huge, I would say, because suddenly it's a possibility. We have the means, and we have the knowledge to do series who can travel so much. So I would say it gives us self-confidence. We can do it. Yes, we can, as Obama said. And suddenly we have that feeling in Sweden also. So I think it's fantastic for us. We have a new mindset now. And I would say it's about confidence. It's about confidence. Suddenly you can think outside the box, think outside the country's boundaries. Thinking more of doing long-running series, and I would not say soaps, having that as a main target, not just thinking one thinking about two seasons or three seasons. So it's more a mental thing, I would say, a new way of thinking. We don't have to be so narrow. Suddenly the world opens in some ways.
We need to talk. Elizabeth. Oh, can I call you Elizabeth? I want you to help me catch a killer of women.
One key thing to think about is being global. And with that, I would say, be very local in your stories. But in the genre and in the emotions, they have to be global.
Nu behöver du någonting annat än du vred nyckeln om.
Nej, jag vred om och sen så låste sig allt och sen så började den räkna ner.
Hallå?
Jag snackar med bombkillen.
We are producing for ourselves, and then we also do co-producing with different production companies. So that's one of our bread and butter thing. We do it all the time. And I think it's very nice and it's very good because it makes the talent go around. It keeps everybody, well, it's very creative because you need new people, and it's like the blood in the whole system. It's changing, it's new ideas, and new persons, etc. So I think that's a key factor. We can't be total reliant on the outside market, so to speak, because we have to know the skills by yourself. We have to produce, because producing is like a muscle. You have to train it all the time. And what I think, that when you stop producing yourself, you're not as a good coach for others also. So it's this combination, I think, that's a challenge. At the moment, we are doing the second season of The Bridge, together with Filmlance and Nimbus Film from Denmark. We are doing Real Humans, the second season, which has been a huge success at Arte. What I heard today was that they have doubled their viewing Arte on just with Real Humans. That's fantastic. We are producing that together with Matador Film.
Lugna dig. Ni kan handla, städa, diska.
Herregud, du läser väl tidningen? De används som sexleksaker.
Älskling, snälla du, det är en familjemodell.
Du, Tobbe, är det inte dags att lägga sig nu?
We have now started to develop original web series. So I would say that's a key thing for us, because it's a little bit cheaper for us, and also it's more edgy, because we are not connected to, you know, a special slot. So we have a lot of different series in developing now, and it's, I would say, that's one of the gardens for new talent, how we see it, to develop, to try things, because we can be more edgy. So that's going on at the moment. Can't be exposed. That's how it is. That's how it goes. We have four series which we are producing, four long running, and we have four miniseries. And we are using the miniseries. My colleague Maria Nordenberg, who is a producer also, she's done something called Don't Wipe the Tears Without Gloves. And we have also a thing called the Death of a Pilgrim, which is about the assassination of our late Prime Minister Olof Palme. Another one is about AIDS. And I would say these are quite more artistic programs. They are with a higher level in artistry, if you can say so. So I would, and they are huge, have been hugely popular, and they have also walked abroad. So. I think it's extremely important to have these as a ground, the series and the miniseries. I think it's a very good combination. It's just fun being a TV producer at the moment. we are sailing. We have nice wind in our sails. That's lovely. It's fantastic, and the audience like it.